Yeah.
He was on the cross.
Uh-huh.
He allowed himself to die.
Yeah.
He allowed himself to be put in a borrowed tomb. Why? Because if it's borrowed, you're not keeping it because you don't need it.
That's it. That's right.
All night Friday.
Yeah.
Stayed right there. Yeah. All day Saturday. Stayed right there.
Yeah.
All night Saturday. Stayed right there. But oh, it's Sunday morning.
Yeah.
He got up so I can get up.
Yeah.
He got up so you can get up.
Yeah.
He got up so you can get up. So you can know that you got power.
Yeah.
You're working power.
Yeah.
And because you got power, when you don't want to fight, you gonna fight.
Yeah.
I'm decreeing and I'm declaring and I'm prophesying there was somebody in this room. When you don't want to fight, you gonna fight. When you want to give up, you're not gonna give up. When you want to cry, you gonna wipe those tears and keep on going. When you feel broken inside, you gonna find a way to pick yourself up and keep walking.
Yeah.
That's what you will do. Why? Because nothing but death will keep you from it.
Yeah.
Nothing. Open up your mouth and say nothing.
Nothing.
I don't think you believe it. Nothing.
Nothing.
You'll be better because of it, but you gotta go through it.
Amen.
I'm
to tell you today, you're going to be better. Forget, like, Mother's Day is nice. We all feel good on Mother's Day. Monday's coming.
Right.
And we all know how you feel about Monday. But after surviving suicide, the Lord allowed me to change my perspective. I enjoy Monday. Monday is a hard reset for me. You know how sometimes you just can't hit the shut down button on your computer? When you go down and say shut off, no, sometimes you gotta hold that button down until it shuts off. And then it restarts and everything is fresh again. Monday's my hard reset. On Monday I say, now I can do this. Now I know I'll be able to do this. I have a list of things to do. You gotta have a, what you gonna do with your life? You can't go around life willy-nilly. You gotta have a plan. Successful people have a plan. They wake up and work the plan. What do you wanna do?
That's real.
Lift your hands. And saying nothing but that will keep me from
you.
Bishop, is it okay if I pray? All right. I want to pray for, and this is not a Mother's Day message, maybe, but I want to pray for men or women who feel like I was the one that was over here, but now I moved over here. And this is a safe place to be honest and transparent about it. If you can't be honest and transparent in church, I don't know where you're going to be honest and transparent. There's so many people outside the four walls of the church because they think they can't come in here and get what they need.
That's right.
So that's why they stay in the club.
Right. That's real.
But here's the good place. I want to pray for those of you who feel like God is touching me, but I need to touch him back. He's already made the provision, but I'm the one that keeps moving. And I want you to come right here in the front, and I want to pray for you. Lord, right now, remove the fear of anyone who feels like I don't want anybody. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Your life depends on this. Your life is depending on this because some of us, I'm going to put myself in this, some of us have moved so far and we once knew what it felt to be in right relationship with God because we were there. We were there. When we woke up, we kind of felt him and now we're just like, I don't know. It just doesn't, something's just not, you know what I'm talking about? Something's just not right. Today is the day that you're going to rededicate yourself to getting back over to the right side, to being right next to Jesus, to putting your nothing but death will keep me from it on it. Amen. Can you lift your hands right where you are? And I want you to close your eyes. I don't want you to be distracted by anything. I want you to begin to think about you. And this is not selfish, because if you don't take care of you, you can't help anyone else. I want you to think about where you are right now and where you want to be in God. Because once you get to where you need to be in God, he will take care of the rest. Amen. I want you to think about what needs to be removed from your life that you keep going back to, that is keeping you from getting close to Jesus like you need to. That thing you thought you could handle, but instead it's handling you. That thing you thought, I'm strong enough, I'm bold enough, and I can play with this now, but now it's playing with you and it's making a wreck of your life. That thing that has turned you into a puppet, that is controlling every aspect of your life. After today, no more. No more. Open up your mouth and say no more. No more will I be controlled, say it, by the lies of the enemy that makes me think I must dwell with him. I am a child of the King. My God died and rose again for me to have life and life more abundantly, which means I've got the power to loose myself from the things that have me bound. Lord, right now, in the name of Jesus, we ask. Before we ask for anything, we just want to say thank you, Jesus. Collectively, open up your mouth and just say thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to still be alive. Because many of us have done some things and been in some places and got caught up in some things that should have stuffed us out. But God, you protected us and you were right there. So we say thank you, Jesus. Lord, some of us have gotten back into some places that we said, Lord, if you get me out of this, I'll never go back. But we went back again. So before we even ask for anything, we ask for forgiveness. God, we want to say we are sorry. We're sorry. addictions, God. God, we ask you to please take the taste away, Lord. The people that they are addicted to, my God and my Savior. We ask right now, God, that you please let them know they can do it. They can do it. They can really walk away. They can really walk away. And not only that, they can stay away. And they don't have to turn around. They don't have to go back to it anymore, my God and my Savior. Lord, right now we ask that you heal broken hearts. There are some people right now on this altar who can't feel you because all they feel is pain. God, it hurts so bad and they don't know what to do. All they want is the pain to stop. So God, right now we ask that you go inside and do major reconstructive surgery on the heart, God. Allow them to know they will love again. And one day they'll look up and laugh again because the pain doesn't hurt anymore. Right now, God, we ask for physical healing over people who are in so much pain that they have stopped praying to you, God. We know if you did it for the woman with the issue of blood, you will do it for us, God. So right now, from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet, we command that we are healed. We decree and we declare that we are delivered. We decree and we declare that we are set free. We decree and we declare that no weapon that is formed against us shall be able to prosper. Now, I have prayed for you. But right now, I want you to pray for yourself. Because you know exactly what you need. Just take this next moment, these next few moments. If it's your heart that hurts, lay your hands on your heart. If your mind needs to be regulated, lay your hands on your head and say, God, do it, please. I want you to pray for yourself. He hears you.